I managed to find the data and transfer it to your OSD.
That's very good news indeed. Thank you.
Just give me my credits and I'll be on my way.
You bet. Thanks for all your help, Commander. Oh, thanks again. That data will be very valuable once I get out of here.
Certainly wasn't human.
No hitting the colonists, even if the Thorian makes them fire on us. That's what the gas grenades are for.
Very well, Commander. Let's go.
Thank you. tried to fight it, but it gets in your head. You can't imagine the pain. I was supposed to be their leader. These people trusted me. It wants me to stop you, but I won't. I won't!
Can't believe the colony held out as long as it did.
These people are brave, but the Gath are relentless. My people know this better than anyone.
Thank you.
All right, we just need to find this creature and determine Keela, what is that?
That does not look like any plant I've ever seen. This may be problematic.
Invaders, your every step is a transgression. 1,000 feelers appraise you as meat, good only to dig or decompose. I speak for the old growth as I did for Saren. You are within and before the Thorian. It commands that you be in awe.
You gave something to Saren, something I need.
Saren sought knowledge of those who are gone. The old growth listened to flesh for the first time in the long cycle. Trades were made. Then cold ones began killing the flesh that would tend the next cycle. Flesh fairly given. The old growth sees the air you push as lies. It will listen no more.
Give me what I need and I'll strike back at the one who betrayed you.
No more will the Thorian listen to those that scurry. Your lives are short, but have gone on too long. Your blood will feed the ground in a new growth.
Thank you.
find more of these things.
Thank you. my line
of sight.
They're in
my sight.
Thank you.
I suppose I should thank you for releasing me.
Is everything all right? Are you hurt?
I am fine, or I will be, in time. My name is Shiala. I served Matriarch Benezia. When she allied herself with Saren, so did I. Benezia foresaw the influence Saren would have. She joined him to guide him down a gentler path. But Saren is compelling. Benezia lost her way.
You chose to side with Saren. So did Matriarch Benezia.
Benezia underestimated Saren, as I did. We came to believe in his cause and his goals. The strength of his influence is troubling.
She tried to manipulate Saren, but in the end, her plan backfired.
Asari matriarchs are among the most intelligent and powerful beings in the galaxy. How could one fall under Saren's control?
Saren has a vessel, an enormous warship unlike anything I've ever seen. He calls it Sovereign. It can dominate the minds of his followers. They become indoctrinated to Saren's will. The process is subtle. It can take days, weeks, but in the end, it is absolute. I was a willing slave when Saren brought me to this world. He needed my biotics to communicate with the Thorian to learn its secrets. Saren offered me in trade. I was sacrificed to secure an alliance between Saren and the Thorian.
Saren's pretty quick to betray his own people.
He was quick to betray the Thorian, too. After he had what he wanted, he ordered the Geth to destroy all evidence of his existence. Saren knows you are searching for the conduit. He knows you are following his steps. He attacked the Thorian so you could not gain the cipher.
What's the cipher? And why did Saren need it?
The beacon on Eden Prime gave you visions. But the visions are unclear, confusing. They were meant for a Prothean mind. To truly comprehend them, you must think like a Prothean. You must understand their culture, their history, their very existence. The Thorian was here long before the Protheans built this city. It watched and studied them. When they died, it consumed them. They became a part of it.
Just give me some plain answers. Where is the cipher?
The cipher is the very essence of being a Prothean. It cannot be described or explained. It would be like describing color to a creature without eyes. To understand, you must have access to endemic ancestral memory, a viewpoint spanning thousands of Prothean generations. I sensed this ancestral memory, the cipher, when I melded with the Thorian. Our identities merged, our minds intertwined. Such knowledge cannot be taught. It simply exists.
I need that knowledge to stop Saren.
There is a way. I can transfer the knowledge from my mind to yours, as I did with Saren. Try to relax, Commander. Slow, deep breaths. Let go of your physical shell. Reach out to grasp the threads that bind us, one to another. Every action sends ripples across the galaxy. Every idea must touch another mind to live. Each emotion must mark another's spirit. We are all connected. Every living being united in a single, glorious existence. Open yourself to the universe, Commander. Embrace eternity.
Thank you.
I have given you the cipher, just as it was given to Saren. The ancestral memories of the Protheans are part of you now.
What was that? Commander Shepard, are you all right?
I saw something. It still didn't make any sense.
You have been given a great gift. The experience of an entire people. It will take time for your mind to process this information.
We should get you back to the ship, Commander. Medical needs to know about this.
I'm sorry if you have suffered, but there was no other way. You needed the cipher. In time, it will help you understand the vision from the beacon.
I want to know more about you.
There is nothing remarkable about me. I was merely one of Matriarch Benezia's disciples. For nearly 2 centuries, I followed her, learning at her feet. When Benezia revealed her plan to join Saren, she gave her disciples a choice. Only those who were willing had to follow her. Many felt her plan was too dangerous. But I believed in her. I thought she could turn Saren away from his insanity. Instead, we joined him in it.
Is there anything else you can tell me about the Thorian?
When the creature enveloped me, I became part of it. But I still don't truly understand it. So alien, so ancient. Its exact age is impossible to know. It measured time differently. 10,000 years of hibernation broken by a few frantic centuries of activity. Its mind was awesome, magnificent. It transcended all classification. And now it is gone.
Don't tell me you feel sorry for that thing.
The Thorian was a unique life form. A sentient being that lived for 50,000 years, maybe more. There is nothing even remotely like it in the known galaxy. I am grateful you saved me from a life of thraldom. Yet I cannot help but feel some sorrow for the loss of such a rare and remarkable creature.
Tell me more about this ship Saren has.
Sovereign is alien. I do not know how it was built or where it comes from. Its design does not match that of any known spacefaring species. It dwarfs any vessel in the Citadel or Alliance fleets. Its weapons are devastating, its defenses virtually impenetrable. With it, Saren believes he is unstoppable.
You said Saren uses it to manipulate his followers.
The indoctrination. There is an energy about Sovereign. You feel drawn to the ship. It makes Saren's arguments more persuasive, more compelling. Spend enough time in Sovereign's presence and you will lose yourself. There is no other way to explain it.
What else can you tell me about Saren?
There is little I could tell you that you do not already know. He's powerful, he's charismatic, and he is dangerous. Once I followed him, blind to his true nature. But now I see he's leading the galaxy into an age of darkness and suffering.
I want to know more about Benezia.
Benezia was greatly respected among our people. A powerful biotic, even for an Asari. She was widely known as a teacher of philosophy and religion. She always sought the paths of peace and harmony. She joined with Saren because she hoped to turn him away from his path of destruction.
Instead, she became one of his most powerful allies.
As I mentioned before, Matriarch Benezia underestimated Saren. Be sure you do not make the same mistake.
Now that you're free of the Thorian, what are you planning to do next?
If you allow it, I would like to stay here with the colonists. They have suffered greatly, and I played a role in their suffering. I would like to make amends.
The colonists will need all the help they can get. They'll be happy to have you on their side.
Thank you, Commander. May fortune smile upon you.
I can't believe it. Zhong says we'll have all the money we need to keep this place running. It's because of you, Shepard. I can't thank you enough.